Hey guys, today I want to talk about my project I was working on. So I played a little bit of Echo the last few days and yeah, decided to write a mod for it so I can make some new items and recipes. And Echo is an real-time simulation where you play with other players together and build a society. And the game is very nice and easy to mod. So on your installation, you have some Steam apps. So the game is always running on a server. So you have on the server, folder, there are mods directory, and there is the core. And in this folder, all the default and vanilla, stuff is listed. So for example, you can go into items and look on to an compost item, and then we see how they write the code. And also in this directory there's a README from the developers where you where it's described how to create a mod. And also you can use this channel I will link in the description. So this user already built mods for Echo a few years ago and it's really into it, and he's also hosting a huge Discord server where you can get help and set it at set the mod development up yourself. I also watched all his videos a few times and used them to create the mod. And yeah, and in this project, to create a mod, you need to write C sharp or C++ code. I don't know. I don't even know. So it's like built on the .NET framework. And yeah, you need to can write this code. You can need to specify some skills, and this structure is necessary to the so the game understands. Also, you can you need to use the Echo dependencies. All of the how to set this up is described in the videos from the key. And yeah, I wrote my first few items here and then decided I want to automate this whole process, so I don't want to write this code. I want to write some one file, and so I created a project called like Echo Mod Generator. So in this project, it's all about having one JSON file where you specify some recipes and some items you want to add, and then the codes runs and generates you the whole mod. So for example, I just created this video mod JSON file, so we can create, for example, a new item called, I don't know, soy. Oh, soy milk already added, so video item, and we can also specify a description, video item made in the video. Can also do a description name and use some text on it, and specify max text size, so we can also specify way more attributes. So in this class, for example, they're all listed, they're all attributes listed to which can you can specify. So yeah, this is an array, so you have this whole structure in your directory in this project. I will this code is also will be also open source, and there you have some attributes like usings, the namespace for the mod, the recipe, and this is also an array of objects. So and this structure is also defined, so some of them are required, also the input items. So you specify it, it's very easy. You can just copy this whole row and add another one. So we can just add a soy milk 2, for example. And then you go in der Helper Punkt in der app.index and there you specify which file name you want to use for the generation of the mod. Yeah, and then we can just delete first of all these few files, and then we run the app index, and as you can see it also outputs us a JSON file where the item specified. So this is used for the Unity project where we specify the textures, and also it generates this whole this whole CS file where all these items, soy milk, I two and video item is also added. Of course, video item, we should definitely not use this. Yeah, we should maybe do it like so. And then, yeah, the code is generated with all the requirements. Of course, this is always also work in progress, this whole project. So we can copy this, and it should work if we just paste this file inside our directory. But we can also paste it in my Visual Studio project. So I need to adjust the namespace so it's working free. And yeah, of course, this item, this recipe at the top is using the blueberry smoothie item, but we did not add it, so we delete this recipe. Syntax looks fine, so we save this. And then we just build my mod. Then we need to locate this repository, my mod free bin debug netzwerk, and it's written this minute ago. So we copy this build file, go to mods, and yeah, we can delete my mod and so on, and then we have this added into our mod. So we can just start our echo game. So I'm using just a solo local hosted server, so this server is running on my machine. And then yeah, it's always takes a moment for echo to load and to start the server and so on, and to check everything and to run the integration tests and so on. So yeah, the textures. So in this generator, so the echo is loading in the background, we just generate the code, and echo will display the items with no icons if we don't specify them. To create some textures for the items, you need to drop an Unity 3D file inside the mods directory. So this is a Unity project, and in this project we created some objects, and the naming of the objects are the similar or the same namings like in the code. And if the namings are the same, the echo mod or the echo engine will automatically just load this icon for this item. So we will I will show it in a few minutes. But so in this case, for example, the video item does not exist in our Unity scene, so it has no texture. But the soy milk item I already added will be added and has a texture. So to create this Unity mod project, you can definitely check out the videos from the key. But I found it very, very complicated. And on one of his videos, where he also created this whole 3D model, which also still works, so the videos are up to date. He added a download for his Unity project. So in this case, I just downloaded it, and we can show an explorer. So I just downloaded it. I will also link this link, of course. And yeah, this is the zip file, extracted it, also doubled it. And then I just downloaded Unity Hub. So this is like the Unity Hub with all versions inside, and then it's automatically gets the versions from this project if you have extracted it. And yeah, asks you to install this the correct version, and if it's installed, yeah, it's very, very easy. So I made this whole process a year ago, and it was way more complicated. So with Unity Hub, I guess it seems very easy to me. So yeah, you just copy this, you ex download the zip file, extract it, and open it with your Unity Hub. Then it will download and due to the fact I have already the editor version installed, yeah, it's just opening up. So in the meantime, Echo already loaded. So yeah, this is my world I was working on. And in the mod, for example, we specified video mod. I can make it. We can also close this whole mess. So we specified the blueberries movie recipe, which needed the blueberry item, so I needed to delete this recipe due to the fact we have no blueberry as movie item. But we also added this soy milk recipe. So this is this object is located in the recipe array, and this will generate a recipe. So here we specified the skill we need, and the naming, the table it's crafted on, the input items, the amount, and so on. And the skill required, and also of course we added the soy milk item. So if we go to our mill and scroll down, so here we go, we have the soy milk item, and if we yeah, and the eight. So I have already some due to the fact it's a dynamic value, it's just 8, so it's the half of it. Of 15, yeah, but the time and the recipe was added, so it works fine. We can also, yeah, just write soy milk in the chat and it will edit. So the food is also applied. At the moment, you can't eat it due to the fact it isn't a food item, so this is still a work in progress. Yeah, but we can also give us the video, and as we can see, we just received the video. And there we go with a description item made in the video. So, and this is the default if no texture is available icon. Yeah, and we can't craft it due to the fact we did not add a crafting recipe for this item. And yeah, I just left the game, and in the meantime, the Unity project has loaded. So, it's you don't see anything. So, on the left, we have our. I don't know, it objects, I guess. It's, I don't work with Unity, so this is my second time working with it. So I have no best practice or something like this. And yeah, so you have your items, and so this directory is you don't need this, but it is yeah, it was added by the key, and I used this project. So yeah, and then you have this naming, so we just go there and can just replace the naming. So we could, for example, we just copy the soy milk only one time and say video item, and now Echo will load this object due to the fact the video item is also added in the C code. And then we have this yeah, split and full image, and this the icon, yeah, full name also needs to be specified, so we can. So on the right, we specify video and then full image, and then we can specify a sprite. And for example, yeah, we could just use, I just use, yeah, the blueberry texture. So I could show you something real quick. For example. If you're dropping, so we can go inside the Explorer. If you, for example, pasting a PNG file in this directory, so and you want to add it to the icon, so it isn't shown in this list, and this is the fact due to the fact that the texture type of this item. So you can yeah navigate at the left, and then have you have all your pictures, and then you need to specify the texture type to be a sprite 2D and nothing else, apply, and now also this yeah texture kind of changes, and then we can, for example, yeah, use the yellow bottle, for example, as icon. So we just foreground also specify the yellow bottom, And also the key mentioned you will always save it, so this, yeah, there is no style. And then we can go to mod kit and just build the current bundle. And then yeah, we just override your, so we're already in the Steam app directory. Override this, say yes. This will take a few minutes. Nah, n no, no minutes. Yeah, then we just build it. And we can start Echo again. And then each the video item should have the texture. While Echo is loading, oh no, I also added a possibility to create world objects, but it is very hard to create some 3D models for you in Unity. So in the video of the key, he also have an example object he places, and this still works. So I also added something and had some, so it's still working. Nevertheless, so you can use it. I will update my generator to have, yeah, some more item types, like for example the food item is still a work in progress, so you can specify carbs and proteins and vitamins and the hours until waste, and also then the game, so it will use another template, so the game also, yeah, realize the item as a food item. And yeah, so, and yeah, you can specify like infinite amounts of items, for example. You can just do it and it also will generate them in the code. And we can just check, for example, I guess in modgen 2, yes, we can say we use modgen 2 as data source and generate this. And then, yeah, also here is the crafting table added, so my table, and this also works. Yeah, I guess I will just show it in the next video if I make another video about it. Here, as you can see, we are loading the Unity project, so it's downloading the Unity thing file from. So it is, if it is a server, you would download it, but due to the fact it's local, you don't need to download this, you just load it. And then we join the world. There we go, already have the texture. So the video item has the texture. And at the moment it's kind of sus, so it has no background. I don't know why. Shouldn't happen. Yeah, so as you can see, the Unity part of this whole mod generation is still not, yeah, like the best, I would say. But it works, and it works fine. So if you are interested in it, I will share the GitHub link to this repository, so you can check it out and create your own mod. And of course, you want to have textures, you always need to like locally install it, or ask me if I could also generate you some Unity yeah, icon projects. Also, yeah, I do it manually, but yeah, I could help you. But of course, I also all only learned it using this video, so you should also be able to, yeah, watch these videos from him, download his file, and then yeah, it should work fine. And this mod generation also with default items, I guess, also is fine. The next, or not the next, the last thing I would say is, as I mentioned, so there is a README from Strange Loops where it's very, very simple to follow and how to override some default vanilla recipes, for example, or add new recipes. And so you could also reduce this. And of course, I did not test it locally, but I saw it, and it's already mentioned in this README that you can also just copy this CS file I generated, and you don't need to build it yourself. You can just copy the CS file. For example, we can reveal in File Explorer. We could check it out. So we copy the CS file and go to our mods directory and delete this one and paste it in. So we could try it out. Did not check it if it's working. But you can also try it out yourself if you want to. Oh, okay, so it's the wrong direct or the wrong folder I put it in, so it said it was ignored due to the f so it needs to be put inside the user code directory. Oh no, okay. Yeah, it's so you should not interrupt this echo launching. Okay, chill. Yeah, the server is still running, so yeah, no, it should be closed, and yeah. Echo is launching. So we will test it out. It's also the first time for me using this only at CS. The server crashed. Okay, so I guess you should maybe try it yourself or ask someone on the Discord server how to use mod CS files. But also when you set the development IDE or the Visual Studio Code up, like the key mentioned in these videos, you could also build it yourself and then it should always work. And yes, so thanks for watching the video. I guess it was kind of helpful. If you have any questions, you can hit me up on Discord. That's the best way, I guess, to stay in contact. And yeah.